all of these things are because that's how you separate yourself. When you come in and you speak up and you project yourself, when you stand up and you introduce yourself and you sound like you know what you're talking about.
Your project work to stay beyond news when everybody else is walking out the door and you got a project in line, but you're so intact and you're so focused that you gotta get this your deliverable out. This is it, right? This is your moment. And I'm sure like that you spoke about, you know, if you wanted to be out for 2 years at 12:01. But you gotta make those decisions. Like Dr. Daniel said, you gotta make a sacrifice. I make a sacrifice all the time. I'm a single parent. I have to travel. I get to travel. One of the great things about my job is that I can travel around the world. I had to go to The Hague this past summer. I didn't even know another opportunity somebody threw my name in there. Next thing I know, I'm going to call and have a week to prepare to get to The Hague in the Netherlands, right? I'm sorry, I feel like I'm just talking to myself, so I'm sorry. So, you know, you have to, so the first thing in my mind with a young child is, what am I going to do with my daughter? She's sitting over there, she's trying to get that kind of talking about.
Network, and to keep your brand of who you are, no matter where you are in the community, and also to reemphasize what the gentleman said, you know, not everything is easy breezy, not everything is gonna just come to you and be a cakewalk. You will have to make hard choices.
One question for us. Once you move a little closer to the top, is who can you trust? If you get the chance to get an interview with somebody for your dream job, if when you leave that table, they say, I trust this person, that's what they're gonna do. Is 100% trust?
I'm a junior. Maybe we spoke about how Jacob's employees, minorities, and things like that. I had a question like, what characteristics that you look for in an employee?
So at Jacob's, you know, obviously you wanna have the technical skill set, the technical ability, the education, and the, you know, whatever the job position is requiring you to have. But just as a whole person, you wanna be able to bring your best self. You wanna be prepared. You wanna be organized. You wanna be professional. You wanna be on time. Everything that you're learning right here, right now, everything that you're learning in school is not an important point. But you have to prove yourself. It's so happened that I met my boss now, and he was like, oh, do you want an internship? And I'm like, no, I'm looking for a job, you know. And he's like, oh, we don't have a job opportunity, like an internship.
Maybe they do know how to step out and go beyond just their day-to-day work. You know, what do you do outside of work that adds value, that makes you stand out? So I always look at those things. Just like the people that are here this morning sitting before you, we're doing things outside of our regular job, not because we're looking for the next opportunity, but it's something we want to do. And it goes back to, you know, the volunteer opportunity was turned into something else. You never know, but the reality is, are you on time? Are you dressed properly? Do you know how to speak properly? Do you know how to project yourself? All of those little intangibles that I instill in Akima, who's sitting over there, and she talks about, Dad, you're always telling me this and that. All of these things are because that's how you separate yourself. When you come in and you speak up and you project yourself, when you stand up and you introduce yourself and you sound like you know what you're doing.
And Dr. Daniel, you will see them frequently. Dr. Daniel and Dr. Sharice as well, because they are both amazing veterans and mentors.